We have introduced SASA. Essentially, SASA estimates the action value for a given policy. By combining it with the policy improvement step and iterating between policy evaluation and policy improvement, we can obtain optimal policies. Now, let's move on to Q-learning. Q-learning is a very classic algorithm that is still used today, particularly in its variant, deep Q-learning. The main difference between Q-learning and SASA lies in what they estimate. Mathematically, Q-learning directly estimates the optimal action value. Therefore, it doesn't need to alternate between policy evaluation and policy improvement because it directly estimates the optimal action value. Let's look at the Q-learning algorithm. As mentioned earlier, I won't repeat the background, so I'll directly present the algorithm. It is very similar to the SASA algorithm. First, let's look at the second equation. If the state action pair SA is not visited at this moment, the Q value for this SA remains unchanged. Now look at the first equation. For the current visited state action pair ST, AT, we update the Q value. Here, QT plus 1 equals QT minus alpha T times QT minus the rest. Its structure is identical to SASA, except the TD target is different. In Q learning, the TD target is RT plus 1 plus gamma times the maximum of QT ST plus 1, A, where we optimize over A. In comparison, SASA selects A based on the current policy instead of optimizing over it. What mathematical problem is Q-learning solving? SASA solves a Bellman equation for a given policy, estimating its action value. Q-learning, however, solves a different problem. It solves the Bellman optimality equation. This equation is given as follows. On the left, we have Q, and on the right, we have the expectation of RT plus 1 plus gamma times the maximum of QST plus 1A. The maximization step over A is included here. This Bellman optimality equation differs from the Bellman optimality equation we introduced previously. Why? First, it includes an expectation. Second, it is based on action value rather than state value. Nonetheless, it remains a Bellman optimality equation. For more details on this, you can refer to my book. Here, it's sufficient to know that Q-learning aims to solve this Bellman optimality equation. The Q value obtained eventually is not for any particular policy. Instead, it is the optimal Q value. This optimal Q value corresponds to the optimal policy. Okay, we talked about the basics of Q-learning using just two slides. The first slide shows the Q-learning algorithm, and the current slide explains the mathematical problem Q-learning addresses. You may be surprised. How come you just used two slides to introduce the important Q-learning algorithm? We will further explore many interesting properties of Q-learning, including illustrative examples. However, the fundamental information is indeed contained in these two slides. The reason is that we've laid a good foundation in previous sections and chapters. If you haven't studied the previous sections or chapters, it is impossible to well understand Q-learning. The contents of reinforcement learning are very systematic because the later parts heavily rely on the previous ones. Understanding the Q-learning algorithm is just the beginning. Next, we'll discuss some properties of Q-learning. The first property I will introduce is the concept of off-policy and on-policy. This concept isn't unique to Q-learning, it applies to all reinforcement learning algorithms. I will use Q-learning as an opportunity to introduce the two concepts. In a reinforcement learning algorithm, there are two types of policies. The first is the behavior policy, which interacts with the environment to generate experience samples. The second is the target policy, which is constantly updated and eventually becomes an optimal policy. Previously, in methods like SASA, we implicitly dealt with these, but now we explicitly define them. Based on the behavior and target policies, we can categorize reinforcement learning algorithms into two types, on-policy and off-policy. When the behavior policy is the same as the target policy, such kind of algorithm is called on-policy. In this case, a policy is used to interact with the environment, to gather experience, and then improved upon. After updating, the policy is further used again for interaction. This iterative process is on policy. Off-policy algorithms, on the other hand, occur when the behavior policy and the target policy are different. For instance, a behavior policy might interact with the environment to gather extensive experience samples, which are then used to improve another policy that eventually converges to the optimal policy. This approach is off-policy. Why do we introduce the concepts of on-policy and off-policy? The purpose is to explain that the SARSA algorithm we previously learned is actually on policy, meaning its behavior policy and target policy are the same. On the other hand, Q-learning, which we just introduced, is off policy. This means its behavior policy and target policy can be different. One significant advantage of off-policy methods is that we can leverage prior experiences, which were generated using different policies. For example, a behavior policy might be highly exploratory, covering a wide range of state action pairs, which helps in estimating the action value for each pair. Conversely, if we use the target policy both as the behavior policy and to generate experiences, we might face limitations due to the policy being greedy or epsilon greedy, leading to insufficient exploration and difficulty in estimating the values for all SA pairs. How to determine whether a given algorithm is on policy or off policy? This question is straightforward to answer if you well understand the concepts, but it can be confusing otherwise. Specifically, we have two ways. First, check what the algorithm does mathematically. Earlier, when introducing SARSA, TD learning, and Q learning, I explained that each solves a specific Bellman equation or Bellman optimality equation. Knowing this is beneficial in identifying whether the algorithm is on policy or off policy. Second, check what experience samples are required by the algorithm. This involves looking at the samples needed by the algorithm. Let's look at the three algorithms we have studied: SARSA, Monte Carlo learning, and Q learning. First, let's look at SARSA. SARSA is on policy, meaning that its behavior policy and target policy are the same. Now let's explain why SARSA is on policy. First, we can examine the mathematical problem this algorithm aims to solve. Previously, we discussed that SARSA mathematically solves a Bellman equation. This Bellman equation is for a specific policy. Here, R represents a reward of given SA. R satisfies a certain probability, and the next state also satisfies this specific probability. The action taken at the next time step satisfies this probability, all under the given policy. Second, we can examine the algorithm itself, which we are already quite familiar with. The reason it is called SARSA is that it uses the terms ST, AT, RT plus 1, ST plus 1, and AT plus 1. When ST and AT are given, which means we are updating the Q value of ST and AT, the subsequent RT plus 1 and ST plus 1 are actually independent of any policy. They are entirely determined by the probabilities PRSA and PS prime SA. Of course, we don't know these probabilities, so we use sampling methods. In short, these two are independent of the policy. However, the fifth term, AT plus 1, is policy dependent. It is an action sample based on the policy pi at state ST plus 1. It's clear that pi t is the behavior policy, because it's used for sampling. So what is the target policy? This is where we refer back to what we've just discussed. We know that SARSA is estimating the action value corresponding to pi t, which is then used to update pi t to obtain a better policy. Therefore, pi t is both the behavior policy and the target policy, meaning the algorithm is on policy. We can draw a diagram. What would this diagram depict? The policy pi t is used to generate experience samples, and then the samples are used to estimate the action value q pi t. This estimated action value is then used to improve pi t, resulting in pi t plus 1. Hence, pi t is both the behavior policy and the target policy. Next, let's consider the Monte Carlo learning. Is it off policy or on policy? In fact, it is on policy. Note that the concepts of on policy and off policy are not restricted to TD algorithms, but apply to all reinforcement learning algorithms. Why the MC method is on policy? First, what mathematical problem does the MC method aim to solve? It aims to estimate the action value. To do this, it obtains a long sequence of an episode, calculates the return, and then uses this return to approximate the action value. Essentially, this is the equation used. It's quite clear from the process. Suppose we have a policy, say pi. We use pi to generate a trajectory. We then use the return obtained from this trajectory to approximate the estimation of q pi. The q pi obtained is then used to improve the policy pi. Thus, within this context, Pi serves both as the behavior policy and the target policy. This is why the MC method is on policy. Now let's look at the third algorithm, Q-learning. Is it on policy or off policy? In fact, Q-learning is off policy. This is unlike the previous algorithms such as SARSA and the Monte Carlo method, which are both on policy. Why is Q-learning off policy? Let's analyze this from two perspectives. First, we examine the mathematical problem that this algorithm solves. Q-learning aims to solve the Bellman optimality equation. While a Bellman equation is for a given policy, the Bellman optimality equation does not involve any specific policy. Or we can say it only involves optimal policies. From another perspective, let's examine what samples are required to implement the Q-learning algorithm. It involves ST, AT, RT plus 1, and ST plus 1. As previously mentioned, if ST and AT are given, then RT plus 1 and ST plus 1 do not depend on any particular policy, because they are determined by the probabilities PRSA and PS'SA. So, what is the behavior policy in Q-learning? The behavior policy is responsible for selecting action AT at state ST. Then, what is the target policy? In Q-learning, I calculate the Q values and then I check which action has the highest Q value and choose that action as the new policy. As the Q value gradually converges to the optimal Q value, the target policy also converges to the optimal policy. Therefore, the behavior policy and the target policy in Q-learning are different, making Q-learning an off-policy algorithm. Next, we introduce the implementation details of off-policy Q-learning, which will provide a clearer view of how Q-learning is implemented.